Spartan Space are a young, innovative company based in Marseille and founded in 2021. They are attempting to carve out a niche as a commercial space company with a focus on enhancing Europe's capabilities in space technology. Over the past 3 years, Spartan Space has ventured into developing everything from spacesuits to lunar habitats, aiming to make space accessible to all. This vision aligns with the growing trend of space commercialization across the industry. What makes Spartan Space particularly intriguing is their dedication to enabling humans to live and work in extreme environments, be it on the lunar surface, in the vast emptiness of space, or potentially in the future on Mars. Unlike many startups that are heavy on presentations but light on tangible products, Spartan Space has been busy building, demoing, and exhibiting its hardware, as you'll see later in the video. Let's look at the technology Spartan Space is using. We will focus on two areas Spartan Space is best known for, a lunar habitat and spacesuits. Eurohab, a semi-permanent inflatable lunar habitat. Spartan Space has experts with deep knowledge of materials suited to extreme environments. Underwater habitat pioneer Jacques Rougier, astronaut and Nova Space president Jean-Franco Clairvoy, and architect specializing in space projects Barbara Imhoff. The founder, Peter Weiss, himself has over 20 years of experience in extreme environments as head of the space division at COMEX, a part of the French space agency and ESA. With this highly experienced team and supported by 10 engineers, the startup has set itself the mission of developing ergonomic, modular and comfortable habitats for living safely in space and underwater. The Eurohab, an inflatable lunar habitat developed by Spartan Space, is designed to function as a secondary living quarters for astronauts during future lunar missions. This habitat is particularly useful for expeditionary tasks, where an area of interest is identified that's too distant from the primary moon base for a day trip. Typically, astronauts are limited to a 2 km walk per day on the moon, which can be extended to 10 kilometers with the aid of a rover. By deploying a base camp or a smaller habitat like Eurohab to these remote sites, astronauts can travel from their main base to these locations, stay for several days, and use a habitat as a temporary home while they explore or conduct research. Spartan Space is interested in providing these secondary habitats as a service, e.g. renting the habitat for a period of time. Peter Weiss, the CEO of Spartan Space, says, "We designed it as a permanent refuge that can be rented to space agencies, as SpaceX does for transport. Spartan Space's lunar habitat is designed to meet some difficult challenges. It must be robust enough to withstand unpredictable meteorite showers, despite its inflatable nature. This structure needs to be completely waterproof to keep the highly abrasive lunar regolith, the dust that covers the moon's surface, from entering the habitat and posing a risk to the astronauts' health. Additionally, it must provide substantial protection against radiation and solar flares, which are frequent on the lunar surface. Inside, the habitat has to sustain life by supplying oxygen, water, and energy, requiring complex systems developed in collaboration with partners, like Air Liquide. With diameters of 7.3 meters in height and 6.4 meters in diameter, this habitat is spacious enough to comfortably house up to 4 crew members for missions lasting up to 14 days. One of its key features is its mobility, allowing it to be easily relocated from one lunar site to another." The CEA, the French Alternative Energies and Atomic Energy Commission, is working with Spartan Space on various solutions to ensure the energy autonomy of the refuge. This could involve integrating high-performance flexible solar panels directly onto the inflatable structure, or using a hydrogen-powered fuel cell, either supplied by the crew or produced on-site by electrolysis of lunar ice using air-liquid fuel cell technology. Also under consideration is the use of 3D printers, for example based on locally sourced materials such as lunar regolith, to ensure the production of parts for habitat maintenance. The Eurohab lunar habitat can be delivered as a payload by robotic landers, such as ESA's Argonaut, serving multiple functions like living quarters, a safe haven, a science station, storage facility, thereby enhancing the operational range and safety of lunar explorers. Strategically placed on the lunar surface, particularly near points of interest, like the lunar South Pole, Eurohab aims to bridge the gap between safe landing zones and exploration targets, increasing the exploration radius for astronauts. A multi-chambered airlock should keep lunar dust at bay so that the habitat can be used for recurring missions. Regenerative fuel cells and solar panels on the exterior allows the habitat to recharge while not in use. Ground controllers can monitor the habitat's condition and vitals between missions. Eurohab would come equipped with sleeping quarters and computer systems, and crews would switch out parts as needed for the habitat, such as solar panels and electrics. But the hope is that the habitat would last at least a decade and support multiple crew cycles. Spartan Space isn't interested in building every single item in the habitat. Our idea is to work with industrial partners who can provide us with solutions, says Rice. Eurohab and the NASA Artemis program. Eurohab is positioned as a potential contributor to NASA's Artemis program, aiming to establish a sustainable human presence on the Moon. Its design as a secondary habitat could be crucial for extending mission durations and exploration ranges, aligning with the broader goals of international lunar exploration. The shelter is planned to be usable in lunar conditions around 2030. Now let's turn our attention to another piece of technology that Spartan Space is developing, specifically an IVA spacesuit. Europe is involved in the Artemis program that plans on going to the Moon and then onto Mars. New spacesuits are needed in preparation for these manned exploration missions. Spartan Space has been chosen as the prime contractor for a project involving the development of a European intravehicular activity spacesuit. To carry out this mission, the company is working with the design teams of Decathlon, as well as the Institute of Space Medicine and Psychology of Toulouse, or MEDES. Let's first explain what an IVA spacesuit is, and how it differs from an EVA, or extravehicular spacesuit. An intravehicular spacesuit serves to safeguard astronauts during the critical phases of launch or re-entry, offering protection against potential emergencies like sudden pressure loss or extreme temperatures. These suits are designed to be lighter and less cumbersome, focusing on providing essential pressure and life support during emergencies rather than enduring the severe conditions of outer space. On the other hand, EVA suits are engineered for activities outside the spacecraft, in the vacuum of space, or on planetary surfaces like the Moon or Mars. They provide robust protection against micrometeorites, radiation, extreme temperatures, and the vacuum of space. EVA spacesuits include advanced life support systems that manage oxygen, remove carbon dioxide, regulate temperature, and control humidity. With the distinctions between IVA and EVA suits explained, we can now examine the specifics of Spartan Spacesuit's IVA suit design. The first prototype of the spacesuit has already been designed with a lightweight, body-hugging design. We provide the life support, says Spartan Space, namely the respiratory system with its CO2 recycling, the thermal environment device, the energy and communication modules. Decathlon is working on materials that are not yet on the market and that were developed for terrestrial applications, but that match perfectly with space applications. MEDES is working on biomonitoring, sensors that will give us information on the state of the astronaut inside our spacesuit. Now let's look at the spacesuit diagram. It's a one-piece suit, pressurized helmet with communication systems and cameras, ergonomic and tactile gloves, linked to the life support system, portable life support system connected to capsule managing pressurization, cooling, communication and energy, fireproof, waterproof, seamless materials, pockets with Velcro, and high grip boots. Testing and certification campaigns are being carried out before putting real people into the suits. In the next section, we'll cover some important milestones Spartan Space has achieved already, and cover a few other space-related contracts we haven't mentioned so far. Okay, let's briefly go over some key milestones for this young space startup. In June 2023, the Dirty Thermal Vacuum Chamber contract was signed. Spartan Space has signed a contract with ESA for the manufacturing of a novel Scenario 3 scale Dirty Thermal Vacuum Chamber. This type of chamber is essential for testing how materials, electronics, and mechanical systems will behave on the Moon, where dust and vacuum pose many challenges. Astronauts have reported various issues such as failing seals, impaired vision, and damage to solar panels due to dust accumulation. These problems can lead to malfunctions or mission failure. The CEO of Spartan Space, Peter Weiss, says, "The dusty vacuum thermal chamber that will be implemented in Luxembourg will be a gateway to the lunar surface. Critical equipment can be tested in high vacuum in the presence of lunar dust. With its dimensions and vacuum capacities, it will be unique in Europe and allow testing equipment before embarking on a lunar mission. The vacuum chamber will help qualify components crucial to the success of lunar missions." In June 2023, Spartan Space, contracted by ESA to propose technical and commercial approach to post-International Space Station low Earth orbit services. This initiative is part of ESA's broader goals to explore and develop options for Europe's involvement in LEO after the International Space Station era, focusing on creating sustainable, commercial and scientific platforms in space. In July 2023, Spartan Space signed a contract with CNES, the French space agency, to manufacture the full-scale functional prototype of the Eurohab concept. Spartan Space will produce a lander mock-up and the Eurohab prototype habitat as a payload to the lander. This mock-up will be one of the biggest artificial lunar analogues ever built. Also in 2023, Eurohab was tested in the Alps. The idea of this habitat is both to allow scientific experiments to be held in extreme conditions, such as in Iceland or Greenland, and to train astronauts in the use of certain equipment. A mushroom-shaped module was installed on the outskirts of the frozen lake of Tignes. "This is a simulation of a mission to the moon," describes Peter Weiss. "In terms of geology, it was interesting to come to Tignes. We are in a crater shape, we have snow, cold. The conditions are ideal. Our goal is to make a European or French contribution to the NASA Artemis missions. Within 2 or 3 years, Americans will walk on the moon, followed by Chinese. We think that Europe can also play an important role." Peter Weiss says the experience has already allowed them to test subsystems, like some life support inside the capsule, and to determine what can be put inside. A crew of 2 astronauts can sleep there, work, go on extravehicular trips. The habitat, named Eurohab, is designed to land alone with no one on board. In February 2024, LISE, the Lunar Integrated Shelter for Exploration, Spartan Space, in cooperation with Thales Alenia, completed a design study for the French Space Agency on a lunar habitat that can be brought to the moon as a payload by a robotic lander. LISE, the Lunar Integrated Shelter for Exploration, aims to design a reusable lunar habitat to extend the exploration of the moon during the crewed missions on the surface of the moon. Future missions targeting the lunar South Pole aim to explore resources vital for human space exploration. However, it can be challenging to get close to these sites of interest while landing in a safe space away from rocks, craters, and other hazards. The design was driven by the need to be transportable to the surface by a medium-sized robotic lander such as ESA's Argonaut Lunar Lander or the Nix vehicle from the exploration company. A design of a lunar surface habitat that does not take into account the means of transporting it to the surface remains science fiction, states Nishit Singh, who led the development team. "Our team strictly respected the capacities of current European robotic landers in terms of mass and volume in order to make sure that the system can be positioned on the surface in the frame of Artemis as a European contribution. The study concept relies on mature technology available in France and Europe." He envisions the proposed concept as a potential first permanent outpost on the lunar surface, marking a historic step as the first house on an extraterrestrial surface. Okay, upcoming events. A full-scale breadboard is under development that will be used as a technology testbed and for analog simulations. We'll be sure to keep you up to date with news on Spartan Space. Be sure to like and subscribe so you will see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the small space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.